Welcome to the new improved on top and hot, the beta stage. We used to look at three stocks per video, and that took about 45 minutes. Now we're only looking at one. That's roughly 15 minutes. It works out better for all sorts of reasons. So what I do on this show is I share my due diligence with you on hot OTC and penny stocks. These are stocks under $5 that you can find on any market, the OTC, NASDAQ, New York Stock Exchange. And I'm particularly looking for those that have the potential to make us money in the next couple of days, primarily. So what I'm looking for is a hot chart and a hot piece of news. I figure if you find a chart that looks like it's ready to break out and you find a catalyst to go with it, you can't do any better than that, except maybe add some buzz online about it. That never hurts, does it? So I've got a stock here I wanted to share with you a couple days ago. OMGA, Omega Therapeutics. She's got two hot catalysts, actually. She has a deal that she just got involved with, and she's got a lot of money coming in because of it. So Omega finished today at $3.64 and just over a 0.5% down. She is on the major exchange, the NASDAQ, where you're going to have benefits. You don't have to pay to trade this. Not getting in, not getting out. On the OTC, you got to pay for both directions. It's horrible. Plus, you get to trade this pre-market aftermarket. There's a lot of activity pre-market aftermarket. What I'm saying is there's a lot of money to be made there. And there's a lot more money, a lot more volume, and let's face it, a lot more monitoring going up on the major exchanges. So these penny stocks in the major exchanges, they're the better penny stock. So what is Omega Therapeutics about? Well, they tell us here, Omega Therapeutics is a clinical stage biotechnology company pioneering the development of a new class of programmable epigenomic mRNA medicines to treat or cure a broad range of diseases. Now, this is a real deep subject, so I'll put it in the easiest terms as I can because it is kind of over my head too. It is a programmable medicine that duplicates and replicates cells, proteins, and peptides, and releases them in our body. And our body responds to them in a certain way. So it's our body doing something rather than taking chemicals and making our body subject to something else. It's a positive medicine. The company was founded in 2017 by flagship pioneering. From what I'm gathering, Omega is a subsidiary in some way, shape, or form to Flagship Pioneering, which has a lot of subsidiaries. And the reason they got Omega is because at the time they had breakthrough research. So what was the relative volume around the company today? Whoa, that's a big drop. Wow, going from an average of roughly 4 million over the last 30 days down to under 500,000 today. Are we too late to the party? I didn't think so. Take a look at the share structure. Well, that's not bad. We got about 55 million outstanding. I have no clue what the float is, but it won't be any higher than that. And believe it or not, 55 million is a really decent float. Market cap for the company is up there. It's at 202 million. Financials for Omega. Are they making any money? Yes. Speaking of this, I need you to pay attention to these numbers so that when I show you what they've got coming in, you'll realize how much it is. At the end of 2022, they had done about $2 million, and whatever it is they're doing, they didn't have to pay anything for it. Normally, that's a digital product, something you can reproduce and sell that didn't cost you anything, or consultancy, just giving advice. I don't know how they did it, but they got to keep all the money that they made. Looking at their quarterly reports, all right, let's get a feel here. Looking over the trailing 12 months, we've got 12. There's about $2.8 million in the last 12 months compared to the $2 million in the annual report of 2022. So we see their revenues are growing. That's a good thing. Looking at the balance sheet for the company, got a lot of money in the bank. They got about $82 million. Total assets, $217 million. Total liabilities less, $142 million. So that gives us positive shareholder equity of $76 million. That's for us investors. We're not holding a bag here. Taking a look at those disclosures over here. We do have a disclosure here, and it actually goes with the news. But the funny thing is, when you jump over here to the news, it's not here. There is a news press, and we're going to go look at it, but it didn't show up here. What does show up is all of these healthcare conferences that they're going to, which there's nothing wrong with that. They're out there showing off their new capabilities with this technology that they've got. This is how you get funding. This is how you get customers. So that's great. But the catalyst, it's not listed here, but I found it. We've got it over here. I've got to make sure to keep this up high enough so you can see what we've got. Novo Nordisk to develop a novel therapeutic for obesity management. Right, we are talking about this company. They've made a deal with Novo Nordisk. It says down here, OMGA Therapeutics today announced a research collaboration with Novo Nordisk, a leading global healthcare company. But not just them. There is also Pioneering Medicines. They're involved in this as well. To develop a novel therapeutic for obesity management. Now, this is very interesting. Novel therapeutic. You know, the only way we've been controlling obesity is by controlling food consumption, whether that be with dieting, suppressing your appetite with drugs or willpower and meditation, or by doing something even more evasive, like cutting your stomach and stapling it, or putting bands on your intestines so only small pieces of food can fit through. They've come up with something completely different. The collaboration will leverage Novo Nordisk's expertise in research and development within the cardiometabolic diseases and OMGA's proprietary platform technology to develop an epigenomic controller designed to enhance metabolic activity as part of the potential new treatment of approach for obesity management. Right. I was speaking another language, right? Well, I found a simple explanation over here in this article. It's about all these things that Novo's involved with. Well, they've got a paragraph here about them working with OMGA. Novo is tapping OMGA to look into the thermogenesis, which is the body's production of heat within tissues to raise the body's temperature. And in doing this, will raise the metabolic activity and potentially help burn fat. This is a completely different approach from other weight loss drugs which focus on appetite regulation. So we're just talking about turning up the thermostat and burning calories. Literally, right? Going back to this article, that is the first catalyst that they've got a hot product, excuse the pun, and they have a huge market. Excuse the pun. Globally, there are more than 800 million adults living with obesity. As I said, the problem is big. I'm not trying to be funny, just all these terms fit. And many of the existing therapeutic interventions for weight management have focused primarily on appetite regulation. So they've got something new, something novel here, something I'm sure any obese person would be willing to try. But the second catalyst is even bigger and better. We're talking about the money aspect. Under the terms of the agreement, Novo Nordisk will reimburse research and development costs. That's big. They're going to pay for all the expenses for research and development, which is a huge expense. But what do they get for this? They get the right to select one target, the puppy out of the litter that they want, to advance for clinical development. There's going to be a lot of targets identified. Novo gets to choose one of them for their own. But wait, there's more. The juicy part. OMGA and Pioneering Medicines are eligible to receive up to $532 million in upfront development and commercial milestone payments, as well as tiered royalties and annual net sales down the road. Well, great, they're going to make some royalties down the road. But this company did $2.8 million over the last trailing 12 months. And now they're looking at, well, we don't know how much. There's $532 million here. And I've got to presume that Pioneering Medicines is not going to walk away with $530 million and leave OMGA with $2 million. However they slice the pie, I get the feeling it is going to be a huge piece for both companies, and it is going to blow away Omega's revenues as they stand right now. When is it going to happen? I don't know. How much is it going to be? I don't know. But you've got a collaboration with a big company. Novo Nordisk is on the major exchange under ticker NVO, and I believe their stock, I saw today, over $110. So it is a big company. So we've got two pieces of news here that should keep this stock running forward, and we should expect a news press come out saying how much they got from that upfront money that they're due. Whew. And I do like the chart. Let's go take a look at it. The best part of doing due diligence, the charting. We are over here at my free trading platform, my playground, Think or Swim, looking at Omega Therapeutics, ticker OMGA. That is a 6-month, 4-hour view with a real nice high bubble about 6 months ago of $10.09 when she was well over the 200. Once she hit that high bubble, though, she fell quick right to the 200, bounced off at once with a dead cat bounce, fell underneath, and from May to November, she fell, hitting a low here of $1.30. Now, off of that low bubble, there's no doubt she changed her trend. Slow and steady, she was climbing for about 2.5 months, went over that 200 with no big excitement. Wasn't until January 3rd we had some sort of event here. I don't know what it was, but it went from about $2.75 to $6.45, well over 100% gains. Came back down hard underneath the 50-day SMA, and right now she's come back up and she's laying right on top of it. 200-day SMA is on an uptrend right now. Now let's give a little more perspective to this. Whenever I have a huge surge or a big drop, I like to grab my Fibonacci, and you poke both extremes, the high and the low, of that surge or drop, and then you get these supports and resistances, algorithmic supports and resistances. We normally get them by connecting them to price points in the past. We're not doing that here, but these are tradable. You can absolutely trade them because the price respects them. It's weird that way. Now, the first thing I look at is the halfway point. The upper half is positive zone. The lower half is negative zone. If it has a big run up and falls back down and stays above the halfway point, there's a stronger likelihood and possibility that it's going to climb. If it comes underneath the 50, there's a stronger likelihood it is going to fall. And that's what we've seen here. She did come down underneath the 50. We had a nice bounce here. She got up on top and then lost it for some reason right here and then fell back down. Now, she has been underneath this one they call the 78. You don't have to name them. It's at $3.55. She has been working this one, bounced off it here. She tried to get on top of the next one up, which is right up underneath the 50, and she's struggling with that. She's come back down, and as we said, she's landed on her 50-day SMA, that is. This is the 50% mark of our Fibonacci, which is where we need it to get to. It needs to push up to there. So right now, we're at 373. Our 50% mark is up there at 460. That is a push. We'd have to get a very strong push there. And look, we have no volume to talk about. Now, there is volume there, but compared to this, there's hardly anything. Let me zoom in, see we got volume. But remember what we had today, less than a half a million. So maybe these are a million a day, but there's not been a lot of volume, relatively speaking. Right now, she is more or less going sideways in this channel area. Oscillators don't show a lot of strength. Our PPO is coming down right now, pretty weak. Already had a negative crossover on our MACD. She's about ready to cross the signal line, and look at all of our red bars here. That shows down pressure. And this shows down pressure. Our RSI has fallen from 65 down to 45. Taking a look at our 20-day, 1-hour view. So we've had our big jump off of the 200. We poked it here, went sideways a wee bit, and then ripped. Came down slowly, crossed that 200. We were down there for a week. We've got back up on top of it, but it actually looks like we are under everything right now. Our price is underneath every single SMA, and all the SMAs are pushing down right now. This looks like it's going to come down further. Now, I would presume, looking at what we can see here, it already respected this algorithmic support that we got from our Fibonacci. You can see the price came down and tapped right on it perfectly. So that's what I'm thinking is going to happen. It is going to come down and tap this. By that time, the 200 will be closer and she should be able to bounce off of that and get up over the 200, ideally speaking. What do our oscillators say? Pretty passive with negative influence. Not a lot going on, but she is still pushing down right now. Everything is weak and our RSI is down to 40. I don't like to see it under 55. That's pretty chilly. And let's take a look at our 5-day, 5-minute. Well, she's all over the place here, isn't she? There's our 200. She fell under it, hitting that low of $3.37. That was about 5 days ago. Got back up on top of that 200 and climbed to a high of $4.36. Roughly 30% spread there over the 3 days. Then fell. Yesterday, a lot. She fell from 436 down to 356, just giving it away. And now she's going sideways the hard ways, up and down, up and down. And it looks like she was on a down push right here, but after market, we see there's a little push going on. Now, look at our PPO and look at our ADX. When they come close, the price is falling. When they start to spread apart, which is what the bottom mouth opening you see right now is doing, it's changing direction. So we do see a change there. We see a change in our MACD. We have a crossover going on right now. And our RSI, which virtually was over the floor, is now pushing up to 45 from 38. So we have some heat showing up on the small charts. The larger charts show a lot of cooling down. But I think after that big surge, it's just a matter of settling down, getting your wits about you, and then taking off again. And let's not forget, she's got two catalysts here. She's got a novel, hot product. I can't help it. They've got this new metabolic drug they want to come out with that helps you literally burn your calories by heating up your body. No more appetite suppression. You know how exciting that's going to be. And then the bigger catalyst, revenues. $532 million to be split between two companies. And I don't care how they split it. I am pretty confident that Omega is going to get more than $2.8 million, which is the most she's ever seen in a 12-month period. So this is big news. And when the next news press comes out and says we have got our upfront portion or a portion of it, that's going to be a catalyst. So I think it's worth putting on your watch list. Even if she isn't ready to run right now, she looks like she's changing trend right now. She is definitely worth a watch. Put it on your watch list, but don't forget to do more due diligence. There is a lot of information that I didn't cover because we're trying to keep these videos short, right? Remember, folks, the more you know, the more you're going to grow. See ya.